Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are now going to combine a video only file and audio only file. This is often done by video geeks, and it's called muxing. That's a technical word, M-U-X. In any event, I am looking to do this the smart way without transcoding, without recoding. This way, I preserve the quality of every single bit by not changing it, but merely just combining these two types of files into one playable file. I am using a program I researched that fortunately is free and happens to do it. It is called xmedia. Now, how this is done is by opening up the files I want, and here the files that I chose to do it is a video file I downloaded from the internet, in this case YouTube, called M4A. That can sometimes include the audio, but in this case I happen to know it's only the video, so I'll do that plus this audio file, which is the matching file M4A. I had to rename it from M4. No, actually, very good. Very good. Okay, now let's do the magic. Okay, so now they're both in there. I could see that they're both in there. And as you can see, it's identifying one as a video and the other as an audio. So the first thing I'm going to do is set the format to match what I want to put out. And that, leave the top is custom. The format is MP4, MP4. Now, and by the way, that's called the wrapper. Let's go into the video portion. And here we're going to set copy. We don't want to change anything. We want to copy the video and not transcode it. Then we're going to go to the audio. In the audio, it does require a trick. We have to, even though we do see the audio there, we have to re-import it as a stream. So now I'm going to hit that, the top one, stream. And we can see now that played, but we do need one third more trick. First of all, let's keep it at copy, okay? That's also very important to keep. We now have to set this little arrow here. If you don't do that, it ain't gonna work. Okay, now, you'd think that that's the end of it, but no, we have one more step to do, and that's to add this as a cue to the project. So let's do that. And as you can see here, it shows that this project will have both a video portion and an audio portion. That's what we wanted to. Now we could rename this, and we could decide what folder. I'm going to pick a folder here under my desktop, and I'm going to call it fixed, let's just say. Okay, good. Now, as soon as we hit OK, it's going to start working on that file. Let's see what happens. And by the way, this should be pretty quick. Okay, now I do have other programs. Ah, we need to do this one last thing. And that is to engage the project. So now you can see it is calculating the time it's going to do. I could have changed the priorities. Here it calls the project. Let's see what happens. Beautiful. Only took 23 seconds. That's pretty fast because, as I said, it was not changing the bits of the codec, but merely combining two. Now, let's look and see if we accomplished our mission by minimizing that window. Let's go to that. And here's our new file, fixed. Let's play it and see if we've accomplished our mission, although you may not be able to hear the sound. First of all, the first thing we could do is analyze it with this nifty plugin that that I installed into my operating system, not technically a plugin, an add-on, called Media Info. And when you install that free program, which tells you everything about any video or audio file in terms of what's really in it, you have the option to really install it as part of the operating system shell. And that will mean it's available as one of the options here when you right-click on any file. That's what it means when something works within the shell of your operating system. In any case, I right-clicked on the file. Here comes my options. This is the one I want. And let's analyze it. And this is showing us we've met our success. What this program does is it says we have video and shows us the amount of pixels, 1920 by 1080. Plus we have audio. The audio, it says the codec was AAC at a sampling rate of 44.1 kilohertz per second. Well, hertz does already mean per second. And here's the video. So let's give it a listen. Now, although you may not hear the audio using this stream capture, let's see what I show. Beautiful. Okay. I am getting video there with the audio. Mission accomplished. Over and out.